Hey everybody, my name is John Orr. I'm a secondary math teacher from John McGregor Secondary School in Chatham, Ontario. I want to share a short story with you about assessment in math class. I'm sure you remember how math classes were structured: lessons, homework, repeat, then tests, and your mark was created by all those test results. I ran my math class like this for about 8 years. What sparked a change for me was when I read these simple words that are written all over the Ontario curriculum document. By the end of the course, the student will. End of the course? Really? I have until the end of the course to assess our learning goals? But I had been evaluating by the end of the unit, or by September 23rd, which is the test date. And like every math teacher, those evaluations of those skills were stuck to a student for the rest of the year, regardless of they improved upon those skills. I wanted my students to learn our course content not just by September 23rd, but just learn them. I wanted to promote growth. I needed my assessment evaluation policies to reflect that, and I want to share them with you. And to do that, I want you to meet Connell. Connell's in my grade 10 math class. Connell also has autism. He functions very well in our active math class. One day each week, along with his classmates, Connell logs into his FreshGrade account, and waiting for him there is a list of current learning goals. Each learning goal shows not only his current progress, but his past achievement on those skills. Connell scans through the learning goals and chooses one that he wishes to improve upon. Here is where FreshGrade is great. It captures and holds all his work. It provides me great insight into his learning. As Connell works to improve his learning goals, he uploads pictures of his work through the app. I get to see that work and provide audio or written feedback, also through the app, web or in person. What I love is that I get to see all that interaction for each learning goal forever. I can see the growth that Connell is making. I love being able to see Connell's thinking progress as he attempts problems. It makes me as a teacher more confident about his ability on the course expectations. For example, Connell uploaded a picture of his work on solving a proportion. He was confused about the nature of proportional relationships. After comment and talking with him, he made the corrections and re-uploaded. That progression of learning stays in his portfolio for us both to see. His next step is to attempt a new problem to show consistency, and then he moves on to a different learning goal. We do this each week, all year long. Time is no longer a factor. Connell doesn't have to compete with the rest of the class on his learning. He doesn't get penalized because he couldn't master the concepts by a specific date. The assessment structure gives more power to Connell while at the same time makes him take more ownership of his own learning. He has choice. He has to assess himself on each goal to know where to improve next. But that routine isn't just for Connell, it's for the entire class. Everyone uses their portfolio to push themselves and show their learning. Assessment is power, not punishment, in my class. And that helped Connell and many of his students be successful this year. Thanks for listening.